COVID-19 may even shrink the brain, study finds. Serious complications are what scare experts when patients catch COVID-19. Severe COVID risks organ failure, poor outcomes, and even untimely death. But a new study revealed that even mild COVID isn't so good for the brain. Researchers found that a mild case might result in faster aging of the brain. Serious infection is a huge threat to the human body. Not only does it threaten vital organs, but it also heightens the chances of permanent damage. Take the nervous system and syphilis as examples. Syphilis is one of many sexually transmitted infections. The bacterial agent is sly and wicked to all unsuspecting individuals. While it shows its presence during primary syphilis, the bacteria will eventually spread quietly during secondary and latent syphilis. This is how it successfully caused an outbreak in 1495 in Europe, where the disease spread among the soldiers of Charles VII of France. Lucky you, antibiotics are widely available today, and they can cure syphilis. But if the disease has reached the brain, there's a possible change in the outcome. The University of Michigan Health explained that syphilis can affect the brain and the spinal cord. Although antibiotics will still work and clear out the bacteria in the central nervous system, damaged parts of the brain due to the infection are likely permanent. The brain doesn't regenerate, unlike the liver. For COVID-19, a study published in Nature showed how mild COVID could impact the brain. Researchers analyzed the brains of those who had COVID and discovered the changes in their brain structure. The first were a huge loss of gray matter and other abnormalities when compared to those who didn't have COVID-19. Next, many changes found were identified in brain areas linked to the sense of smell. We were quite surprised to see clear differences in the brain even with mild infection, lead author Gwanel Dodud told CNN. So, how bad was the loss of gray matter in COVID patients? Dowood explained that it is normal for people to lose gray matter each year, around 0.2% to 0.3%. This is mostly associated with aging. However, in those who had COVID-19, the estimated loss was an extra 0.2% to 2% compared to those who didn't contract it. To confirm that, they conducted a cognitive test for participants. Those who had the greatest loss of brain tissue performed worse in that test. The findings pinpointed brain shrinkage even in mild COVID. That may explain why some people with long COVID also experience cognitive problems. More research should be done to better understand the phenomenon and help those who suffer from post-COVID symptoms. What's your take on COVID-19 shrinking the brain? Do you know someone who's experiencing cognitive issues after getting COVID? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.